Okay, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. First, I will make a review of what we have discussed in the previous lecture. In the previous lecture, we discussed about the utility theory, utility concepts, first, we need to know where we can apply this utility concept. This utility concept can be applied for this scenario in which we are encountered with the single time opportunity, that is for the insurance of the vehicles, cars, etc., or the gambling in the casino. They are the scenario in which utility we applied. Recall in the previous lecture, we compute the expected utility. How do we compute the expected utility? Probability multiplied by the corresponding, these are the utility values. For each of these state of the nature, then make a summation. We found a 77, 79, 80. What is the optimal decision? Optimal decision is the expected highest expected utility, that is 79, corresponding to the decision of D2 for that decision maker number one. Let's talk about the decision maker number two. Have the highest expected utility of 65, corresponding to the decision of decision number one. These are expected utility we have discussed in the previous slide. Now today we will discuss about how do we compute value of the decision. How can we revert back from the utility to the payoff? This is what we are discussing. What we need to discuss. Let's see. Then yes. Recall, okay, one more thing about here. For example, here for the decision maker one, as the expected utility is 79, for the decision maker two, the expected utility is 65. Now what I need to find the value of this utility, or what is the worth. How can they revert back from utility to the payoff? First we need to go to the transformation table. What does it mean? In the previous slide, we talk about these are the payoff value. Okay, different payoff value arranged in the ascending or descending order. These are the utility. These are the utilities for the utilities value for the decision maker number one, and these are the decision maker number two. For the decision maker number one, what we had the utility value of 79. 79 lies in this range. We have the utility for the decision maker one is 79. 7 lies in this range, that is in between the 80 and the 60. Corresponding to 60, we have the payoff values minus 10,000. Corresponding to 80, we have the corresponding value for the payoff value is the 20,000. Noted that 60 and 80, because 79 utility value we need to find, convert back to the payoff value. We do not have 79, but we have the 80 and 60. 80 for the 80 corresponding to 20,000, for the 60 corresponding to 10,000. So let me come back. So here, because 79, we need to find the optimal decision utility 79. We need to find what the corresponding payoff. Whereas we have the 80 and the 60. These are the utilities which were given the transformation table. For the 80, we have the corresponding payoff is 20,000. For the 60, we have the corresponding payoff 10,000, as I just show you in the previous. Now what we need to do, we need to find the, using the linearly interpolation technique, we need to find what is each of the point worth of. So what using the linearly interpolation, then how do we compute the linear interpolation? 20,000, this one minus 10,000 is equal to minus plus 20,000 plus 10,000 is equal to 30, divide by that the 80 minus 60 is equal to 20, divide by 20. So it means it is equal to 1,500. It means each of the utility point, one utility point is worth equal to 1500. Okay, one point is equal to worth of the 1500 payoff, whereas we need to compute for the 79. On the other hand, we have the value for the transformation for 80. It means if I will subtract 80 minus 79 is equal to 1, then I can easily find the corresponding differences from the payoff. Then 80 minus 79 is equal to 1 point. So it means I can find a utility of 79 worth is equal to 20,000, which is the corresponding value for the 80 minus 1500, which is equivalent to 1 point difference. 80 minus 8 here, it is equal to 1 point difference equal to 18,500 is the corresponding payoff value for the utility value 79. Now let's talk about, it will be more clear, let's talk about for the 65. For the decision maker, the optimal decision is he is the optimal decision and his utility, expected utility is 65. Now we need to find where the 65 will lie in the range. For the decision maker 2, the 65 lies in this range. 65 lies is in this range. We need to compute for the corresponding payoff for the 65 value, but it is not available in the transformation table. So we need to make use of the interpolation technique. Correspondingly, 85 corresponding, we found that 85 is correspond to what, the 50,000 for the payoff, 100 is 100,000 for the payoff. Noted these values. 100 is 100,000, 58 is the 50,000. Whereas we need to find for the 65. Now we need to find this one, as we found that we have the utility of 100 for the 100,000, for the utility of 58 for the 50,000. What we need to do, we need to compute for the 65. Then for first we need to find the interpolation for each point of worth using the linearly interpolation technique. So in this case, one point, how do we find the 1 point worth? 1 point worth is equal to 100,000. This 100,000, let me change the color, 100,000 minus 50,000, that difference is equal to 50,000. Okay, as you can see here, 50,000. On the other hand, for the difference between the 100, this one, minus 58 is equal to 42, then we will divide by the 42. It means, what is the interpretation of this one? The interpretation is, each point is 1 point in the utility is worth of 1190 points in the payoff. So 1190 in the each of them. Then because we need to compute for the 65, then either you can use the upper limit or the lower limit, but here they use the lower limit. For example, what is the difference between the 65 minus 58? It is equal to 7. So we can use the utility of these. This is, let me change the color also so that it will be more clear. So we can find the 58 plus, this is the 58, corresponding worth is 58,000. Then 7, the difference is equal to 7. We need to find for this 65. 7 multiplied by each point worth. Each point worth is equal to 1190. It is corresponding to 58,330. So in other words, we can say the utility for the decision maker 2, expected utility is 65, corresponding to the 58,330. So the decision problem is worth more. Which one is the worth more? Which one is highest value? Either this one or this one. This one. We found 58,330 is more than the 18,500. So this decision problem is worth more for the decision maker too. Now let's talk about the decision making, the game of light, game theory. Although game theory is a little bit complex, recall that what is the game theory? That each of the player, each of the suppose I am playing a chess with you. So what I will do, for each of my move, I will check what are my available slots along with the your moves, previous moves with available. So if in order to win the game, obviously both of them will continuously monitor all of the previous moves, etc. So this is what we know as the game theory. Game theory can be used to determine the optimal decision in the face of other decision maker player. Means, what is my optimal decision? I will consider what are the available slots for me. What move have you made? So all of the players seeking to maximize their return. Technically, we can say all of the players, they maximize their game. They want to. They obviously say a single time, single person can win. The payoff is based on the action taken by all of the decision makers. So what are the payoff? Technically, we can say all of the action taken by all of the decision making player. Or for example, playing a chess game, obviously more than one player were there, we need to check all of the players were there. So we will not go into the detail because it is out of the scope for our course, but just for the understanding in the game theory, the same concept for the payoff, etc. Technique, payoff concept what we applied, each of the player, they will try their best to have the find the optimize for their moves, etc. Okay, this is chapter number 3. So what I am trying to do right now, I am trying to solve the assignment number 3. Yes, let me check his assignment. Just I will give a little overview. What is assignment? How little overview I will give. So this is assignment number 3. In fact, a grocery store chain must decide what to build a regular large, extra large store. It means these are the four alternatives or options were there for the chain store in the Seattle Quebec City in the Canada. There is no also option for the or not opening any of the store. For example, for this is for the none. Then the decision depend on the market potential of the state added and it may be for what are the state of the nature, very high, medium, low. So there are four state of the nature and there are four alternatives options were there. Then the potential profit in this case are shown in the payoff table. These are the payoff or potential profit. They are present in the payoff table. They are the payoff table given to us, where positive sign may represent some profit and negative sign may represent some loss. Then determine the maximum profit decision. Recall that in this chapter number three, in the category of decision making under uncertainty, we talk about the maximum, minimax, regret criteria. So, for example, how do we define the maximum? First, we will find for each of the alternative, what is the minimum value? For example, here, what is the minimum value? This is the minimum value. Okay, out of this minimum value, what is the maximum value? Rest of the values, they are negative except this one. The maximum value is 0. So the optimal decision for A is none. Then let's talk about determine the minimax regret criteria. Recall that in the category for the minimax regret criteria, first we will identify what is the maximum value for each of the state of the nature. These are the maximum value. Then out of this, then we will create a regret table. Then a regret, how can we create regret table? table as the rest of the payoff, they are subtracted from the maximum. They will create a new table in which rest of the payoff they will subtract. It means, for how do we compute the first one? We compute 750 minus 350 is equal to 400. We will create, we will make a table. Then in the same way, for example, 700 minus 50, in the same way, first then we will create the regret table. For example, let me talk about how do we create that table for this value as the 170 minus 170 is equal to 0. 170 minus 0 is 170. 170 minus 10 is equal to 160, for example. Yeah. So in this way, we will create the regret table. Once we create the regret table, then for each of the alternative, we will find the maximum value. What is the maximum value? Once we identified the maximum value, then for example, here we find some of the maximum. What is the maximum value for from the regret table? Once we identify the maximum value, then we will find out the what is the minimum value. That will be our answer. Number three, suppose here if I give you the probabilities 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, and 0.1. These are the probability given for each of the state of the nature. Then what is the optimal decision if we use the expected value criteria? Recall that in the expected value criteria, how do we compute expected value? Expected value criteria, how do we compute? We will multiply the probability for each of the state of the nature, for each of the decision alternate. So it means 0.2 multiplied by 350 plus 0.3 multiplied by 220 plus point, let me change the color so it will be more clear. Then 0.4 multiplied by this 170, then 0.1 multiplied by this and make a summation. Then it obviously we will get some expected value. We will get some of the expected value. Then we will then, in other words, we can say each of the probability will be multiplied by the corresponding payoff, make a summation. Once we identify the expected value, this one, then the highest one, optimal decision, will be the highest value with the optimal decision. Okay. Then let's talk about the number four. In the number four, a market research company claimed that they can determine the exact market potential in the settle. How much is such information worth? Exact mark here, what is the mention about the exact market potential? This is the case for the perfect information, because they claim they know the exact market potential. It means they mention about the exact market potential means perfect information. So we will use the expected value of the perfect information, expected value EVPI. We need to come EVPI, expected value of the information we need to find. It is equal to how EVPI equal to expected return of the expected ERE, expected return of the perfect information minus EREV. EREV. How do we compute EREV? For example, we have already computed EREV from the part C, the optimal decision for the expected value EREV. This is the EREV. How do we compute expected return of the perfect information? That the first we will identify what is the maximum value. These are the maximum value for each of the state of the nature. We will multiply by the corresponding probabilities, make a summation. These are the probability. Then we in other words, because 0.2 multiplied by 750, then 0.3 multiplied by 480, then 0.4 multiplied by 170, then 0 multiplied by 0.1, make a summation is equal to ERPI. We can easily compute it, this one. Now let's talk about the question number 2. Yes, calculate the payoff table for the possible percentage change in the three stocks in the stock exchange. How many options were there in the exchange? A, B, C, investment company C. How many state of the nature? We have three: weak, good, and excellent. What we need to do? We need to find the optimal investor choice. Optimus is the case for Maximax. How do we compute Maximax? First, we will identify for each of these set of the necessary, what is the maximum value? These are the maximum value for each of these set. No, this is no, sorry. This is not. This is the maximum value. This one for, then this one is the maximum value. Then this one is the maximum. Out of this maximum value, what is the maximum between them? Then we will find this is the maximum between them. Optimal decision is in investment company B. Now let's talk about the part B. What pessimistic? In the pessimistic, in the case of pessimistic, it is the maximum. First, we will identify what is the minimum value. This is the minimum value. These are the minimum value. Out of this minimum value, what is the maximum value? What is the maximum? What is the maximum? This one is the maximum value. Third one is about the median indifferent investor choice. Indifference means we will make a summation for each of the options. First, make a summation for all of them. Then, for example, 12 plus 18 plus 22 make a summation. Then it will equal to 52. Obviously, rest of the will be added together. Then once you find the make a summation, then find the maximum value will be the our indifferent. Now let's talk about the yes. The following payoff table is the payoff is the in 1 year of the three investment alternative A, B, C, three in opportunities were there. Then what are the state of the nature? Increase, loss, return, along with the probabilities. The other properties were given to us. What we need to do? We need to find the optimal decision expected value criteria. How do we compute the expected value criteria? We need to find the added name column. We need to find, for example, the expected value. Expected value. How do we compute? Probability multiplied by the payoff. 0.4 multiplied by 0.8, 0.3 multiplied by 0.10, 0.3 multiplied by 10, make a summation, then we can compute the expected value for A, then we will find for the B, and we find for the C. Then, once we identify the expected value for all of the three alternatives, then the maximum value is our optimal decision. Find EVPI, how do we compute the expected value of the perfect information? We already, as we saw in the previous, in the question number 2, we already computed EREV already computed for the first step. This step, we have computed the EREV. Expected return of the expected value. Then here to find the EVPI. For the EVPI, we require to compute the ERPI, expected return of the preferred function. What is the maximum value? This is the maximum value. Then this is the maximum value. This maximum value will be multiplied by the corresponding probability. Make a summation. 0.80 multiplied by 0.4, 70 multiplied by 0.3, 70 multiplied by 0.3. Make a summation is equal to expected return of the perfect information. The difference is our answer. Then construct the loss table. Find the expected opportunity loss. Recall that this answer of this question is already in the slide. In the slide, I have computed the expected opportunity loss. But just for your convenience, I am again trying to discuss it. For example, let me first we will identify what is the optimal decision. Optimal value. Yeah, the optimal value. Then we will create a loss table. How do we create the loss table? Rest of the PO will be subtracted. Once we create the loss table, then just apply, just multiply the corresponding probability, make a summation. Then the answer will be the optimal decision. The minimum will be the optimal decision. This is our answer. So I have solved assignment number 3. Now, now let's start today about the chapter number 4 is about the forecasting. What is the forecasting? Predicting for the future. Let's start with a simple example. Can you forecast what today is there any rain or not? What you will do, you will go for the weather.com and they will give us the forecast that might be possible today. There is a 10% chance, 20% chance for the rain. This way, though, then they give us in terms of forecasting. Forecasting means predict to the future, praying for the future. What is the forecasting that the coronavirus will be ended for this year or not? Forecasting means there is a chance. 10%, 20%, 30%, 70%, 80% chance at the end of the year we may have the relief from the coronavirus. So these are the forecasting. These forecasting can be also applied for the almost every field. For example, the bank, they make the forecast. The government make a budget for the forecast. In the forecast, they may forecast what should be the revenue, what are the expenditure. And that's why, so in this way, they will make a budget. So these are the examples for the forecasting. So obviously, forecasting is one of the important subjects for the decision, making the decision. So let us start here again. Let's start with what is the forecasting, where to apply, and what are the examples for the end. Forecasting the positive predicting of the future. As simple as single line, we can say, predict to the future is the forecasting. Forecasting for the rain example. The forecasting is the integral part of all of the business enterprises. All of the means almost all of the enterprises, they must have the mechanism for the forecasting. These forecasting, as I give the example for the bank, they in the bank they forecast what are their profits, what are their loss, what are their deposits, what are their withdraw the money people of the when they make the forecast. The government make the forecast about the budget. Then even our college, they make the forecast number of the students who will register for the course. For example, maybe the large number of the students register for a particular course, IS-201. Obviously, they need to make the arrangement for more number of classes, more number of sections as compared to we can see other sections, because IS-201 is one of the core courses. So again, in as simple as we can say, make the forecast. Let me give the example for the forecasting. As manufacturing firm forecast the demand of their product to schedule manpower and raw material. Example is, take simple example for the Almarai company. Then how do they make the forecast? What are the number of bottles for the milk they will be required for the manufacturing? First, they will check what are the current demand. What are the demand they have? Then they also need, then what are the raw material they will be required, and moreover they also need to, they are the raw material means obviously the milk will be required, something will be required, obviously also required for the manpower that will be required. So then they can make the forecast. This is the forecasting for the product. This is not so simple. There may be some other factor they will influence for the forecasting, but at least we must know familiar about the we know the basics for the forecasting. As an example, suppose let me discuss more example. As service organization forecast customer arrival pattern to maintain adequate customer service. Yes, take simple example for the, we can say OTM, in which the OTM market or the mobile outlet or Ludo etc. What they do, they must have the mechanism so that they know what is the customer arrival means more number of customers they will arrive or less number of customers will arrive, so that they can arrange for the customer service. As an example, suppose during the weekend, that the weekend means from Friday and Saturday, just the weekend, it is expected more number of customers will visit to the Panda for the purchasing. It means more arrival because of the more arrival might be possible. They arrange more customer service, more cashier, because expecting more number of customers during the weekend, they will arrive. So on the other hand, during rest of the days that are we can say Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, during these days, less number of people they may visit to the store, to the mall, to the restaurant. So because of the less arrival, they need to arrange less staff there for the to serve the customer. So these are the example in which we can apply the customer, we can apply the forecasting technique, predict for the future. Then what about the forecasting in the monetary security analyst forecast revenues, profit and debit ratio to make the investment opportunities recommendation. In the recalling chapter number 2, we discuss about the different type of categories for the decision making. That simple example, especially for the big investor, before making the investment, they will check the profile of the country, on the profile in the particular sector. What they need to check about the before making the investment. I mean, they need to check about the what are the revenues, forecast revenues. Means how much might be the profit, what is the revenue, or what might be the loss will be there for, and what might be the debt ratio. Or if you take the example for the bank, these bank, they work on the withdraw the money, deposit of the money for the people. Then these banking, they make a profile so that these bank, they give the big loan to the investors. So obviously they need to check. So again, the forecasting will be required. Forecasting technique will be required. Firm consider economic cost of the indicator. Housing start, change the gross asset product before deciding the capital investment. Take simple example for the housing investment in the housing. Then before making the invest, right, for them in the kingdom, most likely the government make the arrangement for the housing. Whereas in the various countries, if the private companies, they will arrange for the investment in the housing sector. Obviously they need to check, about the opportunities to give. I will give simple example for the forecasting for the car. In the kingdom right now, because they change the regulations, it is expecting forecasting that there will be more demand for the car, because right now females, they are allowed for the driving. So it means we can apply the forecasting that because of the changes, what is the population, current population, current use of the car, what is the population, how many females in the youth age, obviously kids and the old one may not likely to get the driving lesson to work, driving lesson. So what are the youth age were there? Moreover, either they have the buying capacity or they can arrange the finances to purchase this car. What I need to mention, apply the forecasting. Now let's talk about the introduction. Formally, in the previous slide, we talk about the example. Now let's talk about introduction as what for good forecast. What are the advantage do we have the good forecast, and what are the advantage do we have? Reduce inventory cost. Reduce inventory. Good forecast means, for example, take the example for the take this for the Panda again. In the Panda, we have the thousands of the different type of the listed products were there. Obviously, they need to maintain their inventory. Means some of the product they were in the shelf, some of these product they were in the outlet store, whereas the rest of the product they may be in the warehouse or they may be asked for the supplier. So a good mechanism for the forecasting means they can some maintain a mechanism for the what is the inventory, reduce inventory cost, reduce inventory cost. If they know exactly more or less about what might be the sale, then they can easily maintain about the less inventory cost. For example, you may order for 10,000 for the Panda. They may order 10,000 of the milk bottle for the Almarai. But the point is here, either they can sell these 10,000 bottle or not. It means there must be some mechanism for the forecasting. Good forecast means good forecast because they have to pay the money. Lower overall personal cost. Yes. Lower overall personal cost means means good forecast means you know exactly what are the resources will be required, what are the manpower will be required. So it will reduce the cost. Then increase customer satisfaction. Customer are more satisfied. Customer, they are more for the forecasting. Number of more session. So, and for example, I give the example that the for example, right now, I suppose for this course, IS 6. Let I have to apply the what will the forecast number of students they will register for the course. Maybe they set the limit for 20, 25, or 30. Then what they do, if they what they do, they forecast the number of students who may register for this course, maybe in the range, for example, 20, 25 or 30, then only one section will be open. On the other hand, suppose if their forecast is 60 students may register for the course, then they may require to open three sections. So for example, for the some of the core courses, IS 201, this is the core course, it means more number of the students they require to register. So again, this is an example for the forecasting. The forecasting process, then now let's talk about what is the forecasting process. What are the processes that will govern the forecast? The forecasting process can be based on the educated guess. What are the, this process, these educated guess, for example, we can say high executive, with high executives were there in the organization. These executives know, moreover, they also supported by the statistical model. This statistical model, they will help out to have a very good forecast. So these are the examples for the educated guess. Educated guess means high executive along with the supporting statistical model, they are available. Second one is about the expert opinion. In the category of the expert opinion, okay, then for example, we can say, although the method we will discuss later on, the Delphi method, or we can say the we have the query required iteratively, or means expert in their field, we will get their opinions. We will discuss later on what are the expert opinion. The Delphi method is one of the example. Then for the forecasting process, one of the past history of the data known as time series. For some of the forecasting techniques, they require the past data. For example, past data, so that this will be applied through the time series. What is the past data means? How our department, they analyze number of students registered for the highest 466. Means based on some past data, they know that how many students they have passed for the, some of the third level or second level courses, number of students they have completed their prerequisite for this course. So these are the example in which some past data is available. For example, how do we know today will be the rain or does not rain? Some data is available. Based on the data, we can predict for the future. What do you think? What either for tomorrow, the number of coronavirus may be increasing or decreasing? Maybe your answer is past data for the couple of days, they may be decreasing. More or less, they will be around, we can say, they will be around 320, 330, 340, etc. How do you give this figure? Past data is available. It should not be, may not be, for example, the next, tomorrow, what might be the corona cases? Maybe it cannot be something 2000, because you have the past data. In the past data, the value may be around something to 310, 20, 30, etc. So these are the, then, now let's talk about the type of forecast by the time horizon. Let's talk about type of the forecast by the time horizon. In terms of timelines, how can we make the forecasting and time horizon? Or in other words, at the time, what does that mean by time horizon? It's the length of the time over which an investment is made or held before it is liquidated. Or for example, before means it is the some length of the time. Forecasts, these forecasts, they are associated with some length of the time. Let's see what are these. For example, the short range forecast, usually for 3 months to 1 year. For example, job scheduling. As a simple example for the, short range of forecasts is each semester. A semester consists of 4 months. Each semester, they make a forecast. What might the course need to be assigned? What is the number of course need to be sent, Mr. Mohammed Shoaib, Dr. Mutawalli, Dr. etc. So these are the examples for the short range forecast. They will make a forecast for the one semester only. They will not make a planning for the next whole year, no, or 3 year. For the assign the course is an example. That can be applied for the short range forecast. So here job study is work assignment. They assign the work for me for the current semester, and it will be in the range of 3 months, etc. So they may be in the range of 3 months to 1 year. Second time about the mid-range forecast. For the 3 months to 3 year, it may be from 3 year to medium. For example, Yes, for example, take for the budget for the company, budget for the King Saud University, budget of the organization, or budget of the country. They make a budget for the 1 year. As we are familiar about the government announce the budget for the one year. The same you can apply that the so the same you can apply for the budget for the company, profit for the company, etc. So budgeting is an example for the mid-range forecast. Most likely the budget will make for the 1 year, but here where the range can be from 3 months to 3 years. Let's take another example for the sales and production planning. For take sales and production, they make a budget. For this period, for example, what might be the sale? What might be the sale for example, right now there is fiber optic ITC from the Zoom. Then SSG offer Beti optical fiber. So what did they make the budget? That this what might be the our sale? What is for people who like? Another example is for example, Almarai company also make the mid-range forecast for the production line as the mid-range as the for example the what for the for this medium period what might be the what might be the resources will be required, what are the raw materials that will be required. So these are the examples for the mid-range forecast. Then let's talk about the long-range forecast, especially for the big investment. They require a long-range forecast. More or less we can say from 3 years, more than 3 years. These are the examples for the long-range new production planning. Suppose new production planning means some investor, they want to make the investment to a new company. Then facility location, for example, the Ministry of Housing, they want to make a planning for the new facility, new organization, new location they want to develop. So they are there for the facility location. Or suppose that I want to make the investment that because I found a more opportunity for the car because of the change in the regulation. So it means I want to have the new production planning. For new production planning, it is not something that will be, it is required more than 3 years for the forecasting. More than 3 years for the forecasting. Now let's talk about the what are the forecasting different forecasting approaches. Broadly, it can be categorized in two types: qualitative and the quantitative. What is the qualitative? Let's see what are the features for the qualitative is. Used when the situation is vague or unclear and little data is exist. Either you don't have data, for example, new product or new technology. Suppose Samsung or Apple, they have the new series of Apple 12, Samsung 12, etc. Something new product, people does not know exactly right now what are the feature. Either people will purchase, not purchase. So they are the example for the qualitative, in which because we don't have the past data, involve intuition experience. Then what intuition is? The intuition is imagination from the manager or experience. A past experience of the manager, they will be required. Forecasting sale or the entire forecasting sale for the Apple, forecasting sale for the I-12 sector. So then we will go for the qualitative method. We will discuss later on in detail what are the different subcategories were there. About the quantitative method, if you have the past data, if you have the past history, then you will go for the quantitative. Mean use when the situation is stable, historical data exists, past data is available, then you can go for the quantitative. Most likely, for example, they use for the existing product or using the current technology, people they are familiar using the technology, you have the data is available. For the quantitative, because data is available, then we can apply some mathematical tool, mathematical equation, mathematical model. We can apply, use the mathematical technique, model, etc. What is the forecasting sale for the current revision? Or for example, if I want to know what is the forecasting sale, what is the forecasting sale for the, we can say Hyundai, because product is stable, people they are using, people know, people like, does not. Like we know, we can make the forecasting. We will discuss in detail and share in the next lecture. Or today we will stop. No, yes, I need to mention one or two things that we will have the quiz two and quiz three during the lecture timing, that is from 9 o'clock. It will not be in the evening, because what I found that some of the courses students, they have the conflict at 5 o'clock. Some of the students, they may have the exam. I'm not pretty sure about the Faisal, did you get all of the students, they agree or not agree? Faisal, are you there? Hello. Okay, the point is here, one of the students has a conflict of the exam. Then he obviously he in the same date and time, that is the 11th of March at 5 on Thursday, but conflict of the exam. I asked the student to ask that if all of the students they agree, we can change the date or we will do something else. I'm not sure either Faisal is available, not available. Okay, we will stop right now. Inshallah, we will continue. So thanks, everyone. Thank you very much.